fans, and welcome to another season of Miami Baseball. Steven Perkins with you today. Alongside me, Houston Vic and Bennett Wise. Beautiful Oxford. Houston, I'm ready. Spring is upon us.
Yes, it was a little chilly this morning, but the temperature's gone up considerably since then, and it feels great. It's a great day for baseball, so I'm excited to see the RedHawks.
Definitely. Coming off a 5-1 win last night against Ryder. This is the second in a three-game series this weekend at home. First home games for Miami this season. Off to a decent start.
Yes, indeed. Ross Haffey with the home run yesterday, driving in two runs. This offense is starting to find its rhythm. Just going to look to see if the pitching can keep them in the game as well tonight with that 5-1 win yesterday. They're going to definitely look to build off that, but they're definitely excited with how they've started, doing well in that tournament in Campbell College last weekend, and they're building off that this weekend.
Yeah, left-handed pitcher Zach Spears getting the nod tonight. He's posted a 3.86 ERA and 9 1/3 innings pitched. Gave up 12 hits and 5 runs on the season. So, quickly, we'll take you through the Miami RedHawk lineup. Batting first, Kyle Winkler, number 13. Following him is going to be number 2, Dallas Hall. They play left field and center field, respectively. In the three-hole, Ross Haffey, you mentioned, the first baseman, had a home run last night. Cleanup, the designated hitter, Landon Stevens. After him, fifth is Will Vogelsgang on second base. Catcher Hayden Senger follows him up. Right fielder Parker Massman. Third baseman Jordan Stevens. And shortstop Carlos Texidor round out the lineup. As we mentioned before, Zach Spears on the mound tonight.
Yeah, Zach Spears, a big guy, big tall, 6'4 plus guy. Definitely got a good live fastball, decent breaking ball. Actually had English class with him first semester my freshman year, so I can attest that he is a very, very big man. Will Vogelsgang hitting a grizzly 400 this season, was hitting 385 going into the game yesterday, and now is at 400, so he's definitely going to look to continue his hot swinging. And after posting only a 125 batting average in his freshman season last season, however, he was 6-for-6 in stolen bases last season, so the potential was always there. And this season, in the early going, it seems as though he's starting to unlock the rest of it.
Yeah, the only player above 300 in today's lineup for the RedHawks. Like you said, Vogelsang at 400. That is incredible. Few on-base percentages up there, though. He's at 419. Ross Haffey, 422. And Williams, also boasting a 400 OBP. So guys know how to get on base, little money ball, right? Doesn't matter.
Exactly.
Doesn't matter how.
Exactly. You know, can't always get hits to drive those runners in. Might need to play a little station to station, you know, an elaborate bunt here and there, sacrifice. Who knows? We might see him pull out the bag of tricks today.
Hey, they're rocking the old school uniforms. Who's to say they're not going to play some old school small ball?
Exactly.
My favorite kind of baseball.
Absolutely.
Miami in the white bottoms and white tops with red trim and red socks, camouflage hats. Ryder in their cranberry tops with white bottoms, cranberry, and black hats. It's a good look. The Riders of New Jersey.
It is. Come a long way.
The Bronx.
The Bronx.
Not the Broncos.
Not the Broncos as we were informed. Yes.
Too funny. Well, I don't know what exactly waiting on. Just a few more minutes, I guess, from first pitch. Both teams seem ready to go. Umpires down at home plate. There's the announcer bringing out the RedHawks now. With a script M on the front, too. I missed that earlier.
Yeah, the old English style numbering, too. It's a good throwback look today from the RedHawks.
Yeah, I'm a big fan. All right, well, we're going to go ahead and take a quick break here at McKee Field at Hayden Park. When we come back, first inning of baseball. Don't go anywhere. RedHawkRadio.com. Oh, let the sun beat down upon my face. Start
And welcome back to McKee Field. Very excited for the continuing of this home series as Miami goes for the series win against the Rider University Bronx. Again, Miami with the good-looking throwback style uniforms. Zach Spears getting his warm-up tosses in.
91 on the gun right there off the mound.
Definitely a live fastball. Definitely keep the hitters off balance. Number 17, Joe Simone, outfielder for a Rider to lead things off, it appears.
Yep. So you got, I think, two more left, they say. So just about to get underway. Handful of people shuffling in now. Filling up a little bit more than it was earlier. Like we mentioned, chilly this morning, but warm as the day goes on, about 45 in Oxford, not a cloud in the sky, so great day for baseball.
Absolutely.
Every day is a great day for baseball, I think.
Couldn't agree more. Scratch that, it'll be number 5, Kyle Johnson, to lead it off. Second baseman, the sophomore, out of Jackson, New Jersey. Center fielder off to the right a little bit as Spears kicks and deals. Taken for ball one. 92 on the gun, though. Second pitch. Down in the bottom of the zone, strike one. Spears evens up the count at one apiece. Popped up behind home plate off to the right, foul. So two strike count for Spears early on. He's in a good rhythm, it looks like. The 1-2. Right up the middle, over to second baseman Vogelsgang, over to first base. Easy money. One down.
Not too bad showing there for Miami. Spears moving quickly, keeping a good rhythm on the mound.
Absolutely. Number 17, Joe Simone, the outfielder up now. Sophomore out of Wayne, New Jersey. High and outside for ball one. Again, 91 from Spears, so consistent velocity coming out of the gate. 93 that time, 2-0. Down low, strike one. Umpire seems to really like it low in the zone today. Spears kicks, deals. It's a bunt, but that'll go foul for strike two. 2-2, one down. And Joe Simone's going to take a defensive approach here. Kicks, deals, breaking ball outside. Good eye there from Simone. Full count, 3-2. Payoff pitch from Spears. On the left side, the shortstop. Big throw to make, and he's going to leg an infield single. So Ryder has a one-out base runner. Try and make something happen with the outfielder Harrison McClure up now out of Atlanta, Georgia.
Yeah, good stop by Texador. Just couldn't get the throw off in time, a little bit off the back foot there.
It's a tough play to make there in the hole. Good job staying with it, though, and still trying to make the play there from Texador. Spears, the lefty, definitely going to keep an eye over there on Simone. One down. And That first pitch to McClure is too low. 1-0. 92 still on the gun. Double play formation there. Strike one. Another fastball. A lot of fastballs here from Spears in the early going, Scott.
Yeah, they've been giving him the bottom part of the plate most of the time.
Ooh, check swing, but they're going to say he went around. Strike two. Changed him up there. 1-2. Spears staring down Simone. Chop foul. Count remains at 1-2.
Yeah, McClure just getting a piece of it, staying alive.
The 1-2 yet again is hit right back to Texidor. Textbook double play, 6-4-3. And that'll end the inning.
Just like that. Not too bad.
Not too bad at all.
One hit allowed, infield single, but Texidor turning two, doing a good job getting out of the inning.
Good job, yeah, redeeming himself after the tough play there, batter before. And now Miami's turn to make some noise with the bats.
That's right. It's going to be Winkler, Hall, and Haffey. 1, 2, and 3 for the RedHawks.
Haffey, as we mentioned earlier, with that home run. So definitely going to have our eyes on him and his at-bat.
Soporowski on the mound for Ryder, left-handed pitcher from South Amboy, New Jersey. 6'2", 225 sophomore, so a couple big boys on the mound today.
Yes, indeed.
Definitely have that presence.
Getting his whole body into that throwing motion. Not as throwing as hard as Spears, but definitely a lot more movement from his pitches, low, mid-80s. Lot of movement there.
Soporowski finishing up his warm-up pitches. He had 14 appearances last year as a freshman, including 13 starts for the Bronx. It was 2-for-5 with a 6.95 ERA, struck out 44 batters in 66 innings thrown. He did toss 6 or more innings, 3 different starts, and he was named the MAAC Rookie of the Week in mid-April of last season.
Definitely a lot of promise from this guy, just a sophomore, but looking very poised and collected here, ready to go.
If I asked you what two hobbies were listed on his bio, what would you guess?
I don't even know where to begin.
How about fishing and golf? Does that one surprise you?
Not at all. Not at all. Very relaxing, but also very frustrating. Much like baseball, both of those things. Outside, ball one.
Yeah, a little finesse, a little patience, a whole lot of mind.
You know, Hank Aaron once said, it took me 17 seasons to get 3,000 hits on the baseball field. It only took me one afternoon on the golf course. Called ball two. 2-1.
Yeah, just a bit off the outside corner of the plate.
Pop foul down the first baseline out towards the psych building.
Yeah, that is parking lot city. There's a reason I do not park over there.
I made sure I parked as far away from the field as possible. Inside there for ball three, full count.
Yeah, Winkler looked like he thought he wanted to turn into it, maybe decide against it last second. Mm-hmm. Nobody really wants to get hit with a baseball, right?
No, even if it's only going 80. Popped him up very high out there in center field. McClure calling off the right fielder. And there's out number one.
So a couple good hacks there from Winkler. Sent one foul, and then the pop fly just got a little bit under it.
It made him throw some pitches, though, and that's exactly what you want to do coming out. Hall up now. Swinging at the first pitch right to the first baseman. And just like that, there are two quick outs. So a little bit of a different approach there from Hall as opposed to taking a few. He liked the first one he saw and gave it a good whack, but unfortunately, first baseman right there to corral it.
Hey, you don't have to give up that first pitch for free, right? If you like it, swing at it.
Can't blame him. Ross Haffey, the first baseman, up now. Way inside, almost nicked him there. Had to do a little dancing. That'll wake you up.
I think he might have clipped himself with a bat, too, actually.
Looks like a little bit of a breaking ball there, right down the middle, but he didn't like it. Strike one. Low and inside, ball two. Soporowski, very quick to the plate delivery, not wasting any time between pitches.
Yeah, you know, and we saw that as well in the first half of the inning. Both pitchers trying to get in, get out. Seems as soon as the batter steps back in the box, they're ready to throw.
Right. Can definitely be intimidating to a batter, for sure. High for ball three. So another full count here, worked by Miami. Two down now. For the first baseman, Haffey. Soporowski gets a sign, kicks, deals. And that's lifted high into left center field. Outfielder battling with the sun there a little bit, but he's able to catch it and retire the side.
Dallas Clark out in the left field, finishing off that half of the inning. So at the end of one, it is 0-0. Ryder with one hit. Miami unable to muster one in the first inning.
Definitely some good pitching, though, from both sides.
Yeah, I like the tempo. They're keeping guys on their toes. As soon as they step out of the box, adjust those gloves, get back in, pitch is coming right down the lane.
Wasting no time. You like to see that, especially from two young guys.
Yeah, they just seem like they have control of the mound right now, and they're letting you know it's their plate.
Absolutely. Not Soporowski wasn't afraid to come inside either. His first frame, almost nipping some guys here and there. But part of being a dominant pitcher is not being afraid to establish the inner part of the plate.
Yeah, you got a guy like Ross Haffey who went deep last night. Nobody on base. He's not as intimidating in that situation. There's nothing wrong with brushing him off a little bit. Spears dishes his last warm-up pitch of the inning. We are ready for number two.
Jake Bender, the first baseman for Ryder, coming out now. Spears is ready. Here's the pitch. High fastball there, 92.
It just slipped away from him just a bit. He's been working the lower part of the plate first few batters.
Swinging. That's hit high and foul down the right field line, but it's caught.
Good play over there in shallow right, like you mentioned, just getting foul. making the catch, Will Vogelsang.
Running all the way over there from second base. Good play. He's got the speed. He did. He was 6-for-6 on stolen bases last year, and he can certainly cover that ground in at second base. Definitely something you want from your infielder. It's going to be the catcher Stockwell up now. Stockwell swinging at the first pitch, 91, waves and misses, 1-1. Swinging and missing again there.
Big cuts from Stockwell.
One of Ryder's better hitters this year. And struck him out. Was not able to catch up to that pitch the first time Spears threw it to him, and Spears just figured, let's just go back to that pitch two more times, and was able to get the K. Two down now. It's going to be Barbary up now. The freshman. Low, strike one. Spears getting some good calls here. On the lower part of the plate. Popped him up. Should be playable there for the first baseman, Haffey. And it is. So three up, three down here for Miami in the top half of the second. Spears definitely feeling confident as his guys get ready to grab the bats and hit.
Yeah, pitching the theme so far. Shutting down batters on both sides.
You got to wonder who's going to crack first. You know neither of these guys want to be the first one.
Of course. Miami did give up that one hit in the first inning, but responded well, turning two right afterwards. Still unable to find themselves on the base pad, though. See if they can change that here at the bottom of the second.
Getting on base has not been a problem, as we said earlier in the show. A lot of guys with high 300s, even 400s on base percentages. However, the batting average is, for a lot of players, a problem. Team's total batting average, as of today, 241 in total. So definitely something they are looking to improve on today. We were mentioning Will Vogelsang hitting at a cool 400, but the next guy below him is Landon Stevens, who's hitting 267. So definitely a huge gap in performance there.
So the DH from Hamilton, Ohio, Landon Stevens, to kick us off here in the second, bottom of the second, I should say.
Soporowski's going to start him off with a big breaking ball at 72 there on the outside, 1-0. Comes back inside and gets a called strike. Mixing speeds here. Obviously had a conference with coach back in the dugout, and they want to come out and mix it up a little bit more. Foul ball there, 1-2. Same quick delivery, quick to the plate delivery as we saw in the first inning, though. Soporowski kicks, deals. Another foul ball there. So Stevens hanging in there. Fouling off some tough pitches. In on his hands and hit right to the second baseman. Good awareness there. And there is one away.
Yeah, a line drive falling off to the right field side. Easy snag there directly to second baseman.
That's exactly what you want to do, though, when you get a pitch in on the hands like that. Just try and muscle it out there. Unfortunately, there was a guy right where he hit it. Foul ball. Miami coming out swinging here in this inning. They want to get on the base paths.
Yeah, and I don't think they're intimidated by the speed. Is Soporowski just trying to get the bats out in front, make some contact.
Thought about going around for a second, but pulled back, and it's 1-1.
Thought about it a couple times,
couple
I think.
Times, exactly. He had a lot of time to decide there. That was a slow pitch. Another foul ball there. Vogel's gang is close.
78 on the breaking ball that time.
1-2. Vogel's gang not worried, though. Inside, called strike three, rung him up, and he didn't like it very much.
Yeah, I don't know. It was close. He looked like he was trying to lean in and take it off the elbow, but just brushed the inside corner of the plate. Two down for Miami.
Regardless, you got to get the bat off your shoulder with two strikes. There's a high chopper. Second baseman almost lost his foot, but an easy throw over to first, and that retires the side. So a quick couple of innings here in the early going.
Yeah, good pace, like we said. Pitchers maintaining. We're going to go ahead and take a quick break. When we come back, third inning action, still 0-0 here in Oxford. Don't go anywhere. RedHawkRadio.com.
A song for the broken hearted.
Welcome back, Oxford, Ohio. Stephen Perkins with me today, Houston Vick and Bennett Wise. Just getting underway here in the third inning. I'm going to send it back over to Houston, 0-0.
Spears' first pitch called a ball, 89. Still great velocity. Lefty called strike there, one apiece. Hit up the middle. Second baseman playing in the overshift, and he hit way, way out of the shift and was able to squeak out a base hit. Vogel's gang playing into short right field.
Yeah, good hit there by the first baseman, Mahalik. Finds himself on the base pad. Two hits now for Ryder this afternoon.
That's the sign of a smart baseball player right there, seeing the shift and hitting it exactly where they're not. I personally am not a big fan of the elaborate shifts that are populating the game today because players can do something like that. A trained player can do something like that.
Yeah, great show of skill.
Too low there from Spears, 1-0. Here to Dallas Clark, no relation. keeping an eye on him over there at first. Strike one. Spears is going to live right there on that inside corner as long as he can. Low and inside's been getting the calls. Not a good spot to hit. Not the more bad spot to hit. Foul tip. 1-2.
Yeah, they've been real generous with the lower half of the plate, too, and I think Spears recognized that and continue to move that way.
Spears kicks, deals, waved at, and missed. Strike three.
Yeah, good off-speed coming back with 84 after a couple fastballs.
I've probably seen only a couple of off-speed pitches from Spears in the game so far. It's been mostly fastballs, and that's been working out in his favor as Ryder is completely unprepared for the off-speed. It looks like Tecco's setting up for a sacrifice situation here. Spears keeping him close over there at first. Mihalik, the designated hitter. Strike. Pulled back, but it's still in there. 0-1. Tecco, the shortstop. Still looking like he's going to square to bunt. Pulls it back this time. It's too low. For a ball. Tecco looking down for the sign. Something's on. Third baseman crashing in. Popped him up. Bunt is behind home plate. And that'll be strike two. So, got a swing here, Tecco. Hit and run, maybe?
Yeah, Tecco out of the nine hole, just looking to get some movement on the base pad.
Spears with the delivery. That's right to Texador. Over to Vogelsgang. Vogelsgang back to Haffey, and it's safe.
Oh, close play there
close
at first base.
Close play. Bang, bang play. But happy to get the lead runner there. Tecco, speedy runner down there. You got to be if you're going to play shortstop.
Yeah, just floated that off the fat end of the bat there to the shortstop. Came in just a little slow. Texador didn't have a super great jump on it. Sat back, waited for it to come to him. Might have been the deciding millisecond.
Mm-hmm. Spears comes back in with a ball. Still got two outs. Runner on first. Ryder trying to come away with a two-out score, perhaps. Keep this two-out rally going. Pop foul off to the right behind home plate. Spears taking a little bit more time this inning between pitches. Now that he's settled in. In the dirt, ball two from Spears. Good job there by the catcher to keep that corralled. Spears kicks and deal, runner going. And that's a high chopper to second baseman Vogelsgang, but no problem there as it's over to the first baseman Haffney to retire the side.
Yeah, good hit and run there from Ryder, forcing them to go to first base instead of easy trap on that lead runner there at second. But Miami doing a good job getting the out anyway. So giving up two hits, but both times getting out of the jam, no problem. We remain scoreless here in Oxford. 4:28 p.m., beautiful day in the Midwest. Spring keeps sneaking up on us, and then it hides again.
Right.
We'll have a couple days. It'll be 60, 70, a lot of sun, a little bit of spring rain, and then the very next day you wake up and everything's frozen.
Back to normal.
Yep, yep. Sometimes even in the same day.
Right.
It's tough, man. Even for my 10 o'clock classes, the way I have to dress to walk to them
right.
is very different than the way I want to be dressed when I'm walking home.
Right. It's like you're wearing sweatpants, and then you walk out, and it's like, wow, it's too hot to be wearing
sweatpants.
Yeah,
it's 75 degrees and sunny. I got to walk all the way back. But This is an ideal day for me here.
Absolutely.
45 and sunny, not a cloud in the sky. Beautiful Saturday. Life is good.
Life is good, indeed. Soporowski just about ready to get started again. It's going to be Massman, the right fielder. Lineup has yet to turn over for the RedHawks.
Yeah, hitless so far through the first two. Massman, outfielder in the 7-hole from Carmel, Indiana.
Swinging at the first pitch and foul tip behind home plate, 0-1.
Massman, just 3 appearances so far this year. 1 hit, 1 RBI.
Another foul ball there from Massman.
Yeah, Miami's not having any trouble catching up, just a matter of making solid contact now. Massman finds himself in the 0-2 hole.
Soporowski kicks, deals, high and outside. Trying to get him nibbling there, expand the zone. Not a bad call, but good job there by Massman to hang in there for another pitch.
Yeah, look at Soporowski. He is ready to.
And it's another foul ball. This time he straightened that out a little bit more.
Yeah, Matt's been taking his time getting back in the zone, but Soporowski's already grabbed rubber.
He's ready.
Wasting no time.
Massman probably trying to throw Soporowski off tempo.
Yeah, of course, that's the duel, right? Who owns the plate?
Exactly. Low, low ball there. 2-2. So Massman trying to edge his way back into this at bat, evening up the count at 2 apiece. Swung on and missed, strike 3. Foul tipped into the catcher's glove, and Massman's retired.
Yeah, that's tough. You fell off the first two. You feel okay about it. You want to get back in the count. I thought he did a good job, though. Stayed patient. Worked him a little bit. Took his time getting back into the box. Battled back to 2-2, but whiffed on the third strike.
Mm-hmm. Stevens takes a ball. 1-0. Jordan Stevens, the third baseman. Smooth as silk over there. With the glove work over there at third base. And possibly one of the better balls hit by Miami today is caught after a short run by the right fielder.
Yeah, just in off the right field warning track. First pitch swinging.
2 quick outs. The shortstop Texidor out of Puerto Rico up now. And he's going to try and do a little bunt, but can't connect there. 0-1. Inside, strike 2. Foul ball. 0-2. Soporowski kicks and deals. And that's too low. So Texidor trying to work his way back into the at-bat.
Yeah, I don't know. I think Spears has gotten that one a couple times today already. I was kind of surprised they didn't ring him up there.
Mm-hmm. Soporowski, too, got that pitch. He's gotten that pitch a couple times, and there he is trying to go low again, but he evens up the count yet again. 2-2, 2 down. Soporowski's ready. And the pitch chopped down the third baseline. Easy play there. Strong throw. Retires the side.
Well, at the end of three, we are still scoreless. Miami yet to reach base. 0-0 as we get ready to head to the fourth. But first, we're going to take a quick break. Don't go anywhere. RedHawkRadio.com.
Song for the broken hearted.
Welcome back to McKee Field at Hayden Park. Stephen Perkins with me today. Houston Vick and Bennett Wise from Red Hawk Radio bringing you the baseball action here at Miami University. I'll be taking you through the middle three innings as we kick them off with a first pitch strike. Spears rocks, fires outside. Good dig by Senger. 1-1 now the count. Big rip fouled off down third baseline. So 1-2, Spears on top. Check swing. He did go around,
yes,
says the third base ump.
That's tough. But, as they say, he who hesitates is lost.
Lost indeed. Harrison McClure steps up. Right-handed batter. First pitch, hit fouled. Back behind home plate down the first baseline. That parking lot getting a lot of love over there by the Farmer School business.
Absolutely. Ryder, though they do have two hits, they're trying to get back on the base. Early swinging.
Yeah, yet to advance a runner to second base. So Miami doing a good job containing those hits and managing those base runners.
Some good defense played by both sides today.
1-1 to McClure. Outside again. A little bit high as well, 91, but control slipping a bit here in this at-bat. See if Spears can get back in the driver's seat.
Pitch count not getting too up there yet. However, Spears has taken a little bit more time between pitches. That's what throwing 91, 92 will do, though.
And that one missed slow. McClure knew it the whole way. So the first walk of the game puts McClure on first. One out, top of the fourth.
Got to think that Vogel's gang and Texador are both going to be hugging that bag, trying to turn two.
Already done it once. They had a bang-bang play called safe at first after that. So first pitch, ball. And it's time for a chat, says Senger. So he's going to run out, speak with Spears, see if he can calm down those nerves just a bit.
Mm-hmm. Missing outside several times in the last at-bat, walking Simone. This is not a guy that you want to miss in the zone to. play.
On the third baseline, hits the second baseman and a wild throw into the Rider dugout. Send that runner to second, but second out there for Miami. 90 on the gun.
Good stop there by the third baseman, Stevens. Good jump.
So the first runner on second base for the night. It'll be Stockwell with an opportunity here. The catcher for Ryder. Did not hit in his first at bat. First pitch from the lefty, high and outside again, 89. Spears got to find a way to bring that back inside the zone.
Stockwell, the catcher, only hitting .97 on the year so far. However, does have a home run.
The important things, right?
Right. In 31 at-bats. So the pop is there from the catcher.
That one's up the box to the second baseman. Routine play to first. And once again, Miami gets out of the inning.
Good job there by the defense to pick their guy Spears up after he gave up the walk. Defense wins championships, and that's exactly one of the reasons why, is when your defense picks up your pitcher.
Yep, so a walk from Spears and then a fielder's choice followed by an error moves the runner to second, but Spears able to get out by retiring the catcher. We will head to the bottom of the fourth. Still scoreless here in Oxford. Two hits for Ryder, none yet for the RedHawks. Soporowski doing a good job maintaining his rhythm while Spears slowed down a little bit in that last frame.
Absolutely. Soporowski doesn't have the velocity that Spears has, but he's been dealing today. I mean, he's been getting swings and misses. He's been pitching to contact and getting ground balls. Not a bad start from the sophomore today.
Yeah, that ball was moving just enough, I think, to keep the Miami bats off of it square anyway. A lot of foul balls from the RedHawks. Not afraid to swing, like you said, not the greatest velocity, so it's not too hard to catch up to. Miami just looking to put some balls in play here. First three innings, all batters retired, so we're back to the top of the lineup for the RedHawks. Finally come around. Kyle Winkler in the one hole.
Winkler hitting .243 in 9 starts and 37 at-bats this year. 6 runs batted in.
Well, Stockwell's got his gear on, takes one, sends it down to second. We are ready to go here in the bottom of the fourth. Miami base coach is taking their position. First pitch just high, called ball. Good take there from Winkler. Soporowski takes a moment. Rocks, fires. That one cuts inside. Winkler will watch that one fly by for strike one.
Both these pitchers realize that Blue likes it low and in, so they're going to live there, both of them.
Yeah, and like you mentioned before, not a bad place to hang out if you're a pitcher anyway. Tough balls to do a lot with.
That's how you miss bats, and that's how you get ground balls.
Winkler takes pitch three for a ball. Pitch four looked to be in the same spot, but they gave it to Soporowski, so 2-2 now. No outs for the leadoff hitter. Soporowski gets him swinging 83 miles an hour inside the zone. Out number one for Miami, Winkler 0 for 2.
Looked like Winkler had a little bit of a hitch in his swing there, and that's certainly not something you want to have when you're down two strikes against a guy that's been thrown as well as Soporowski has been.
And look at him again. Just intimidating. He's ready to go, giving these Miami batters no time. First pitch of that at-bat's inside for a strike. So it'll be Dallas Hall starting 0-1 in the hole. Second pitch of the at-bat, low, 4-ball.
And that's got to be demoralizing as a hitter. You know, you try and pick some dirt up, put it between your gloves, go through your little ritual, but that pitcher's ready.
Hit to the shortstop, long throw, good dig from the first baseman. What a play to retire Hall.
Great throw there from Tecco. Even better stretch there.
Absolutely.
From Bender.
You know, and again, Miami getting an okay hit, but Soporowski forcing ground balls. Painting that inside low corner.
Getting him to hit it right to his defenders.
Ross Haffey steps in, first pitch swinging. Sends that one foul down the first baseline.
Third baseman going to be hugging the line here for Ryder, probably anticipating the pull.
That breaking ball up, never did find its way back down into the zone, so 1-1.
Soporowski going to have to be careful with that hanging breaking ball, especially against Haffey.
Inside, did not get that call. Soporowski looked a little upset about that. 2-1 for Haffey.
Good patience from Haffey so far.
Low and outside that time, so 3-1. Haffey working well. Again, an OBP significantly higher than his batting average. 419. That one was up. Haffey knew it the whole way, and he'll take that free jog towards first base. Miami with a runner on the base pad. So first time tonight for Miami. See if they can keep the bats going here. Landon Stevens, the designated hitter, up to bat 0 for 1 tonight.
You could tell that the RedHawks are fired up to finally have somebody on base. Let's see what they can do.
Throw down Haffey at first. He's in standing. No trouble there.
Don't think you need to worry about this guy too much.
Looks down Haffey again. Ball hit right field and just carries foul. Make the jog back to the plate. Haffey nearly to third.
Soporowski definitely going to take a little bit more time between these next two pitches, as that ball was well struck deep down the right field line.
Oh and one here for the DH. Checking down Haffey again. Haffey keeping Soporowski on his toes out there.
With two outs, though, I don't think Miami has anything on right now.
Yeah, maybe just looking for that cheeky out if you're Ryder. Big cut. This one fouled as well. Back into that Farmer School Business parking lot. No cars safe today. So, two foul balls from Stevens. Puts him in an 0-2 hole. Soporowski has a call. Kicks, fires. Back up the box, line drive. That one will get down. Haffey's getting the wave. Hits third. Here's the throw at the plate.
Nope.
Got him easily. Haffey about a foot too late.
Oof.
Coach Hayden pulling no punches. Got a decent hit. Why not ring him around?
Why not?
0-0. Get your name on the board. Unfortunately, unsuccessful. So, a well-hit ball there from Stevens. Put it in center field, but good cutoff, good play at the plate.
Well hit, well placed, but yes, I mean, great relay down to the catcher, and Haffy definitely kicking himself there for getting tagged out. But what can you do? It was a really good rebound after a well hit ball there. Soporowski is definitely happy with the result.
Yeah, Haffy almost kind of hesitated there when he was rounding 30. Looked behind himself to check where the ball was.
Textbook fundamental error right there.
Is Texidor okay?
Looks like he fell.
He stumbled in the infield. So still scoreless through four innings. Two hits for Ryder. Finally one on the board for Miami. Haffy was walked. And Stevens sent one out into center field.
Well, Spears definitely happy that his guys didn't have another three up, three down inning. Gave him some time to rest. Maybe that zip will come back to the fastball.
Jake Barbary stepping into the box. Right-handed hitter 0 for 1 today. First pitch high and outside. Won't get that call. 91 on the gun from Spears. The 1-0 pitch. Hit on drive. Down third baseline, but just foul.
Quick hands there from Barbary. That's the idea.
We'll count evens back up for Spears. 1-1 now. Barbary, the freshman from Randolph, New Jersey. Another foul tip. That one right back towards us behind home plate. 1-2 is the count. So Spears out in front. Takes his time. Gets the sign. Brings the breaking ball back in. 76 on the gun. Struck him out. Great pitch there.
Yeah, he has not gone to that a lot today. And so, again, as I said before, Ryder's just not ready for the breaking stuff from Spears.
Yeah, Barbary took a couple pitches to catch up to the fastball, and just when I think he had the timing down, Spears doing a good job slowing it down a little bit. Another foul ball down the third baseline.
Great sequence.
This time it's the DH, Riley Mahalik. Steps back in, 0-1. Contact this time fouled right down the first baseline. So a little left-right action from Mahalik.
Might be another good time here for a breaking ball from Spears.
So 0-2. Spears sent that one just outside. Mahalik thought about it, but wisely decided against it.
Another breaking ball. He saw what happened to Barbary in the at-bat before. Not getting fooled.
1-2 for Mahalik. That one hit well. Left center field. And left fielder able to make the catch. Just didn't have the umph on it. So Mahalik is retired. Two outs now for the RedHawks.
Nice smooth stroke there from Mahalik, but just missed it.
Well, it's a senior, Dallas Clark, up to bat now. He's 0 for 1 on the day. First pitch strike for Spears.
I think it's safe to say that Spears has regained that step that he lost in the last inning.
Definitely looking good in this frame. That pitch fouled off, so 0-2 quickly again for Ryder. Here's the pitch from Spears. Hit well, right field. Inside the track, and again, a good catch there from the Miami outfield, retiring the side. So Ryder getting some bats on balls, catching up to Spears. They got the timing a little bit better than the latter innings, but once again, Miami equal to the test defensively. 0-0 still, middle of the fifth inning. Pretty good showing from Spears so far. He definitely seems more comfortable when he's ahead.
Mm-hmm.
Feels like he has that upper hand. He can kind of work the batters, keep his rhythm, play some trickery, doing a good job moving speeds up and down. Good breaking ball and strikeout there in the top of the fifth.
Absolutely. It seems the game plan for Spears is to get strike one off that live fastball and then throw that fastball again, maybe mix in a changeup here and there. But it seems as the game has gone on, the two-strike plan has been to fool him with that big 75-mile-an-hour breaking ball.
Yeah, hasn't thrown it a ton today, but very effective when he does. So Soporowski heads back to the mound, 13 batters face, one strikeout, one walk, and one hit allowed. It's the throw down from the catcher, so we are ready to go. Stockwell grabs his position behind the plate. Vogel's gang up to bat for the RedHawks. First pitch, high and outside, just by a bit, though. Ball one.
You know, Vogel's gang is going to make him throw a lot of pitches. He wants to keep that average up.
Or so we thought. High fly ball, right center field. The right fielder coming in, making a routine grab, so Vogelsang's retired on two pitches.
Probably a little frustration here from the RedHawks, still trying to figure out this pitcher. A little bit of an unorthodox motion, but again, the fact that he's ready every single time the ball comes back to him, the instant he gets the ball back in his hand, he's back on the rubber. That's got to be demoralizing.
First pitch just a bit high. Ball one for the catcher, Hayden Senger. Like the majority of the Red Hawk lineup today, 0 for 1. Stockwell sprints out, has a quick word with the lefty. Heads back behind the plate, gets a call from the dugout. Soporowski didn't like the first one, takes the second. Inside, gets the strike, so
there's the spot.
Shrug off pays off. 1-1 now. Inside again, that one just too far inside, so Senger back in front, 2-1 is the count. One out in Oxford, still scoreless. Inside again in the identical spot as last time. Didn't get it then, you're not going to get it now. 3-1.
Senger doing a good job working the count.
Oh, big cut there from Senger. Swing and a miss. So full count.
Get coach down there to tie his shoes. He's swinging out of his shoes out there.
Soporowski brings in the full count pitch, but it's hit well right field, and Senger's going to take two. In for a double, a little bit of chatter from the Red Hawk bench.
Good job there from Senger, seeing that the right fielder was a little bit more towards center field, gave him that time to make that turn at first and leg out a nice double there.
Yeah, good at-bat there from Senger. Got ahead early. Maintained composure, let Soporowski battle back a little bit, but then took that full count pitch to right field for the second hit of the game for the RedHawks.
Hits now even at two for Ryder and Miami.
Massman steps in, one out, runner on second. Good opportunity for him. First pitch inside for a ball. Soporowski slows down for the first time tonight. Here's the 1-0. Hit, fouled off right in front of the catcher. So 1-1 now the count.
The key, I suppose, for to slow Soporowski down is to get him to pitch from the stretch, but Miami really hadn't been able to do that until this inning and the inning before that. Their first two hits coming in the fourth and fifth inning, respectively.
Soporowski sends the 1-1 right down Main Street, so strike two for Massman. Massman working with a 1-2 count. Again, that second hit of the game on second base right now for the RedHawks. That pitch is fouled up high behind home plates. And good catch there from Stockwell making the play. Straight up and straight down. Two outs now. Soporowski feeling comfortable again.
Yep. Still a runner in scoring position, though. Cannot get caught napping here.
Jordan Stevens out of the eight hole from Parker, Colorado. Steps in. The right-handed batter, 0-1. First pitch high, never did come back down, so ball one for Jordan Stevens. Soporowski takes the sign. That ball's hit right field. It's going to get foul just past the Ryder dugout.
Not a bad swing there from Stevens.
So 1-1, two outs, runner on second for Miami. Soporowski going to step off, second baseman staring down the runner. Swing and a miss. Strike two.
Big cut. Was probably expecting something slower, and Soporowski got a little couple extra miles per hour on that last pitch at 86. Been topping out at about 84, 85 consistently before that.
So the 1-2 with two outs. Runner goes from second to third in safely on a ball. So one step closer to the first run of the game.
Good call there by the runner to get going, as that was a big breaking ball there that Stockwell had trouble with behind the plate. Anything else, they probably would have been able to get a throw down.
Two-two pitch, hit to the shortstop. Runner's going into home, but easy play at first. Gets the out and retires the side. Scoreless still in Oxford. Miami getting the bats going a little bit that inning. Good hit there from Senger as he works the count. Pulls off the double. Not the offensive prowess that Miami showed last night. Put up five against Ryder in the first game of the series.
Spears, four strikeouts today. And he's going to have to face the speedy shortstop, Teco, again, who was showing bunt quite a bit in his first plate appearance. definitely something for the third baseman Stevens to keep in mind. As his at-bat looms.
A couple more warm-up pitches here from Spears. We'll see if he can get back to that tempo he started the game with. He kind of lulled there in the latter part of the third, fourth, fifth innings. Top of the sixth coming up. He did bounce back towards the end of that fifth inning. Again, like we mentioned, he likes to get ahead early. Work that one strike count. Set up with some speed and sometimes a changeup. Occasionally mix in that good breaking ball.
I'd like to see more of that breaking ball from Spears. Maybe mix it into the middle of the count. Especially against a guy like Tecca who was showing bunt a lot.
First pitch, low, gets the call, so strike one for Spears.
Back to 93 for Spears. He's found some life here.
Second one up, didn't get the call. Sanger tried to frame it, but good eye there from Tecca. Catches back up 1-1. Third pitch of the at-bat, high and outside. Off speed, no good. 2-1 for Tecca. No outs. That time low and outside, so trying to walk his way back in, but down in the count now, 3-1. Not a place Spears likes to be. That one high and inside, so he'll walk Tecca. Not ideal.
Not ideal.
Sending the nine hole hitter to first base for free.
Speedy guy getting on base to start it off, and it looks like somebody's starting to get hot in the Miami bullpen.
Yeah, can't tell who that is just yet. Would like to know.
It's definitely stirring, though. Spears at 66 pitches so far, 42 of them strikes.
His 19th batter faced today, Kyle Johnson, takes on the first ball. And it was a ball. So 1-0 for him with a runner on first, no outs. Good opportunity, Ryder. At the top of the lineup, looking to swing the bats and get that go-ahead run. Spears is just going to check down Tecca, send him sliding back into first. No tag. Spears throws him down again. Just biding his time, waiting to go to the plate. This time he will. That one looked good from here, but just a bit high. So 2-0, Spears is behind again. Got behind the last at bat, ended up walking Tecca. See if he can recover here against Johnson. That one low and in the dirt. Tecca is going to go from 1-2. So Spears moves that runner into scoring position. 3-0 count now.
This is a time in the game where you can't afford to make mistakes. You can't afford to have those lapses.
Showing bunt, but was walked instead. He pulled back last second. So Kyle Johnson walked on four straight, including a bit of a wild one that sent Tecca to second.
Sanger almost dropping and slinging that final pitch out of here.
Well, Sanger's going to have a slow trot out to the mound. He's joined by a member of the Miami University coaching staff. Give that bullpen a couple more minutes. Warming up, we might be seeing, might be nearing the end of Spears' day.
Not a bad start at all for Spears, though.
No, 18 batters faced, 4 strikeouts, 2 walks, gave up 2 hits. He's through 5 so far.
But a big old goose egg under the runs column. Got to be happy about that.
Yeah, you know, every time they get behind, they gave up a couple hits. Seemed to be easy recovery for the defensive squad. So, fresh count for Simone, showing bunt. First pitch outside for a ball. 1-0. Runners on first and second. Simone threatening to move them.
And not a bad decision with from the coaching staff of Ryder, with nobody out. Why not get both of those guys in scoring position with a bunt?
Haffey moving in quick. That bunt foul. So 1-1 now.
Double play is still in order, though, for Miami. Texador hugging the bag closely.
Simone steps around, squares up. That time he took, but it was in the zone. 1-2 here for Simone.
Simone 1-for-2 on the day with a strikeout. He's going back to bunt.
Squaring around on the 1-2. That time high and outside, so 2-2 for Simone.
Got a swing here.
You would think. Steps in, but he's going to square up again. Wants to put that ball down. Again, just outside the zone. No, called him for a strike.
Yeah, I don't know if I agree with still squaring up when you're down two strikes. I think at that point, it's time to get the bat off your shoulder and swing away. Too risky.
Yeah, Simone 281 coming into tonight. 9 hits on 32 at-bats. 1-for-2 going into that at-bat. 1-for-3 now. First pitch of the 1-out at-bat, high and outside for a ball. McClure steps back in. Right-handed batter from Atlanta, Georgia. This one fouled off down the right field line. 1-1. Michael Hendricks in the bullpen for Miami. Spears looks back, gets a call from the shortstop. 1-1, steps off the rubber, checks down second. Take his time. Sanger grabs his stance, sends a call, Spears steps. Takes a look, then throws that one foul down third baseline.
Teco getting a healthy secondary lead. Could be an opportunity for Sanger to try a snap throw down to Vogelsgang. See if he can't get him napping.
Spears slowing down significantly. He was working at the same tempo as Soporowski, that kind of bang-bang grab-and-throw, but that breaking ball works for him there. Picks up another strikeout. And there's two outs just like that. Miami, after having runners on first and second with no outs, battling back with two quick ones. Once again, the defense looks good.
Well, if you're Miami, you've got to be impressed with Spears' ability to be resilient. I mean, here he is with two runners on, and he comes back with a clutch strikeout. There's now two down, and now Ryder's just got to swing the bat. They can't really do anything funny to try and move the runners.
Yeah, you lose your advantage. Can't manufacture a run with two outs, not as easily anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Couldn't get the bunt to work there for Johnson. So 1-0 for the first baseman, Jake Bender. Shears brings that 1-0 pitch outside, so 2-0 now.
Singer having some glove trouble here in this inning.
Yeah, couldn't control a wild one in this last inning either. Spears 2-0 high, and they're not going to give it to him, so 3-0 behind here. See if he can battle back into this count. Trying to avoid loading the bases here in the top of the sixth.
You know Hayden wants to have Spears see this one through, though.
Well, 3-0 pitch hit on left center field at the track, making the catch as the left fielder for Miami.
Spears fired up, a good fist bump there. He was very excited to see his guy track that ball down.
Yeah, good play there. Good read from Kyle Winkler. He's got the legs and able to get out and get under it. So once again, Miami survives. Did not give up a hit in that inning despite putting runners on first and second. So bottom of the sixth in front of us. Soporowski heads back out.
He had a long break, Soporowski did, between the last time he took the mound. This could be Miami's moment to crack the scoreboard.
If you're going to catch Soporowski cold, it would be now. That is certainly true.
Doesn't seem that his command and control has been wavering that much, but Spears with the harder fastball, definitely the fatigue much more evident.
Yeah, Soporowski's still moving pretty quickly, slowed down a bit once Miami put one in scoring position, but other than that, that grab-and-go mentality, trying to keep the batting staff on their heels.
We'll see if he can continue that in this inning.
So it'll be Texidor in the 9-hole, 0-1. Leading off the inning for Miami, first pitch fouled, strike one.
You got to leave those alone.
Yeah, I think that would have been outside. Texidor swings and misses on the 0-1 pitch, so 0-2 now. He's behind early in the inning.
Great job by Soporowski mixing his locations as well as his speeds. He's had a great start today.
Texidor got a piece of that one. He's going to foul it off first base side over the dugout and the stands here at McKee Field. 0-2 outside, Texidor takes for a ball. Miami batters have done a pretty good job climbing back into counts, despite falling ahead early a few times today. Good patience from the batting staff. That breaking ball didn't come down in time.
Oof.
High in the zone.
You gotta get your bat off the shoulder in something like that. Worst feeling in the world, taking a called third strike on something like that.
2-2, and they're going to ring him up. Texidor looking. First out of the inning.
Again, if it's close, you got to put bat on ball. It's a tough pill to swallow, but.
Yeah, that makes that walk back to the dugout just that much longer,
mm-hmm.
Huh? Well, back up top, it's Kyle Winkler. It's 0-2 on the afternoon. One out, nobody on. Bottom of the sixth, first pitch finds its way into the zone.
Seems as though Soporowski has gotten stronger as his outing has gone on.
That one hit fair right over the bag. Winkler's going to take off for second and hang tight out there. So a double there for Winkler standing. He He ripped that ball right down the third baseline.
Well, the left fielder, Dallas Clark, had some trouble with it out there, too, when right when Winkler was slowing up at second. I honestly think Winkler, the leadoff hitter, could have probably stretched that into a triple had he seen Clark fumbling with the ball out there in foul territory and left. But a great hit there from Winkler right down the third baseline, and it appears as though Soporowski might not be long for this game.
Yeah, a visit from the coaching staff. They'll bring the whole infield in. Have a quick chat on the mound.
Yeah, Ryder has somebody up in their bullpen getting hot. Side armor.
Need some binoculars, huh? 44,
44 is what that looks like.
So Jordan Silverman, the left-handed pitcher, junior from Holland, Pennsylvania, up and active in the bullpen for the Bronx.
Reminding me of MLB side armor Darren O'Day. Real quick whipping action from that arm, swinging that leg through. It's got to take a lot out of you when you...
It just does not look comfortable.
No.
Well, number one, Dallas Hall up to bat. Runner in scoring position, one out. See if he can't go join his buddy on the base pad.
Another hanging breaking ball there from Soporowski. He's not going to be able to get away with that for much longer.
Hall 0 for 2 coming into the bat, into the at-bat. 1 and 0 is the count. Soporowski thought about going down a second, but he'll just take a step off the rubber instead. Reset this game. Lefty sends the 1-0. Swinging through that one was Hall, so 1-1 now the count with one out.
Big cut. You know he wanted that one.
He almost looked like he had prepared to take and then... realized he had a pretty good shot at it and just a little bit behind. Hall takes that one inside, but called strike. Just painting that edge of the plate. So 1-2, Hall's behind now. Still scoreless here in Oxford, bottom of the sixth. One out.
Soporowski's 77th pitch on the way.
That went back in the box, but a floater to second base. Mm. He's going to ring up the double play. Just grabs that one and takes one step to second. Unfortunate there for Winkler. Kind of just got caught. I thought it looked like it was going to drop and just hung up just long enough.
Yeah, the wind started blowing a little bit. Looks like it caught it a little bit. And man, not much you can do in that situation. That's a tough break.
Yeah, Kyle Johnson snagging it right off the shoestrings. And then just one step to second.
Good positioning, good play.
Looks like pitching change for the RedHawks. It is going to be Michael Hendricks stepping out onto the rubber. He's got a 6.75 ERA on the season. Only four innings pitched, gave up two hits, three runs. And two walks, had three strikeouts in that game. But did go on to get that W, win in the win column.
Yeah, you know he's going to want to eat some innings here. Keep the RedHawks in this game. Spears, unfortunately, leaving with the no decision. But six strong innings, six strikeouts, only two hits allowed, three walks, but didn't matter as he didn't allow any runs in this start.
Yeah, not a bad showing at all. Faced 22 batters, like you mentioned, six strikeouts. Just started to slow down a little bit towards the end, lost control. Couldn't keep him out. He's high and outside over and over. Mm-hmm. Just a call he was not going to get tonight either. A couple close ones missed high. again, every time that they would fall behind on the base pad and in the count, defense would step up. Nice double play and a few good outs. Nice catch out there in left field in last inning. So a whole team effort on defense for the RedHawks, keeping Ryder scoreless so far. Miami, of course, scoreless as well. Tyler Stockwell up to bat, the catcher for the Bronx. First pitch outside. I'll send it back to you, Houston, for the end of this game.
All right. Hendricks on the 1-0. Wow. That breaking ball looked like it was going to clip him, clip Stockwell there, but came right back. Still missing on the inside part of the plate. Miami electing to go with another power guy. Hendricks hitting 88 on his fastball.
Sanger tried to frame that one for him, but inside again.
Not a great start coming out of the bullpen. Be down 3-0. The first guy you face. Finding his location there. Finding that low and inside corner. 3-1. Still a hitter's count here for Stockwell. Stockwell hits this one straight into the ground. Foul on the first base side. Hendricks going to take a little bit more time than Spears did, bringing a different kind of vibe to the mound. That breaking ball starting way too far outside and not snipping the zone at all works a walk for the first batter faced, and it appears as though Miami's going to have another guy up and throwing already. Third baseman Barbary up again.
Yeah, Barbary 0-for-2 on the day. See what he can do with that walk.
Squaring up. Umpire says that it made contact with the ball. Strike one. Yeah, last time they had runners on. They were trying to put a bunt down. They tried to put a bunt down with two strikes on them, and didn't end up working out for them. Coming away, leaving two guys on base in that last inning. Ball hit over the third baseman, Stevens, into left field. Winkler corralling it and getting it back in. And that'll be a single here. Still nobody out, and deja vu all over again, as Yogi Berra would say. Two men on and nobody out.
So Mahalik will head to the plate for Ryder. Good chance for him to move some runners.
One of two Bronx with a hit tonight. Outside, ball one. A little bit of problem finding the zone for Hendricks early on in his outing. Two men on. Still taking his time, not getting flustered. Quick check over there at second. Getting the low and outside part of the zone. Different location being targeted there from Hendricks. Trying to work away from the hitter as to possibly force a ground ball. Double play. That ball's hit high into the ground. Mahaffey back over to Hendricks, who's covering first. And that'll be out number one, but meanwhile, the runners are able to move up into second and third base
big-time scoring opportunity here for Ryder with the shortstop, Tecco. With the left fielder, Dallas Clark, coming to the plate.
Yeah, good at-bat there by Mahalik. A chopper to first base, pull the first baseman off the bag, force the pitcher to cover, move both runners.
The swinging bunt. Clark 0 for 2 today. He stands in for his third at-bat as he takes strike one.
Yeah, first time checking out Hendricks today. He'll just take the first one, get some timing.
Clark just looking to put a ball deep into the outfield to bring his guy from third home, but he's going to try.
Interesting play there. They called it a strike. Sanger heads up, wanted the out.
Thought he had it.
Bunt fouled into the dirt. Sanger tried to argue that it was fair. Snagged it and threw a tag on, but strike called instead.
Still 0-2. Got to swing the bat here, but I've been wrong before in this game. Wonderful pitch framing the inside part of the plate. Hendricks with a nice rebound after those runners move it to second and third. It's now two away with the shortstop Tecco up. Hendricks trying to slam the door on this inning and get the RedHawks back into the dugout.
Yeah, that's a big pitch there from Hendricks and a great at-bat. Forces Ryder to put a ball in play in order to score a run, take away that sac fly opportunity.
And Hendricks likes that breaking ball that almost like a slider, it appears, that comes back over the plate. He's going to keep using that pitch because Ryder doesn't seem to really have an answer for it. They've just been taking it all the way. That's hit high and deep, foul off to the right.
Yeah, Tecco got wise on that one. He was looking for it that time. We'll see if Hendricks mixes up here.
Such a tough pitch to square up, though. Hendricks comes set and delivers. Big break there to that one, but too high, and it'll be ball one. 1-2 with two outs. Hendricks trying to get out of here. Runners on second and third. The pitch. Swung on and missed. Strike three. And Hendricks, after getting in the jam early in the inning, walking a man, getting another guy on base, and then the runners getting moved over to second and third, is able to strike out the last batter and keep Ryder off the scoreboard. I mean, what a performance there from Hendricks.
Yeah, great job knocking down the last two runners with strikeouts. Good pitches, good placement on the balls. Tecco caught up to the one, sent it foul, and Hendricks came right back after him. So, yet again, Miami seems like they might be in trouble and out of the jam, no problem.
Soporowski back out there. He's at 80 pitches tonight, 50 strikes.
Bottom of the seventh inning coming up here at McKee Field, Hayden Park. Beautiful Oxford, Ohio. First home weekend for the RedHawks. They kicked off with a W last night against Ryder, 5-1. They were victorious. Still scoreless here through 6.5 in the second of a three-game series.
Still anybody's ball game. I mean, both teams have had opportunities to score. Ryder with the most recent one. Back-to-back innings where they've had two runners on, but nothing to show for it.
Ross Haffey, kicking off the batting for the RedHawks here in the seventh.
Just the guy you want in this situation late in the game. You want your big home run long ball hitter. Haffey being patient. Now he's ready, taking a strike, 0-1 there at the bottom of the zone. Soporowski just as quick to pitch again,
as he was at the start. And he fires in strike two. That one at 72. So Soporowski has not really lost a step.
Yeah, truthfully, I'm trying to figure out which pitch Haffy is waiting for. That one looked as good as any.
And that one moving inside, Haffy forced to swing and just got a piece of it, able to foul it off.
Yeah, behind in the count, staying alive. 0 for 1 with a walk.
And close pitch there. Oof, you got to get the bat off your shoulder in that situation. 1-2, though. Low and in the dirt, 2-2.
Yeah, so a little bit of patience. A risky call taking that first ball. Catch one in the dirt. Battles back.
Nobody out, 2-2. And swung on a miss, but that ball is getting away from the catcher. Haffy trucking down the first base line, and he makes it to first on a drop third strike. That from the catcher, Liam Harding, the freshman, making the freshman mistake there of losing the ball on the third strike, rolling all the way to the Miami dugout and allowing Haffy, not known for his speed, to get to first.
Hey, good heads-up play, staying on top of it, legging it out, on base, right?
Stevens, designated hitter, showing bunt there. As that shadow moves in, gets a little bit tougher to see the ball. That bunt in on the hands popped over the Rider dugout. Oh and one here to Stevens. Haffy on there at first. Soporowski with a quick check. Just keeping him honest over there. You know Haffy wants to score if there's anything that leaves the infield. Another bunt. Chopped foul behind home plate. 0-2. Defensive mode for Stevens now.
Yeah, Haffy got thrown down at home. Play of the plate earlier in the game. He went from first. Tried to make that long trek. Score that first run of the game. Coach Hayden waving him through, but just a bit short. Came up about a foot late.
You know he's going to be mindful of that the next time. Coach relaying something to Haffy. That ball leaving the possession.
We'll see what comes of this. Farting. Stevens took that one off the elbow. Coach Hayden coming to get some clarification, but doesn't seem too upset, so.
Odd play there for sure.
You do have to make an effort to get out of the way. Not sure Stevens did that.
Stevens, 1-2. Here's the pitch. And taken, called for a ball. But a risky take there, and he knows it.
High and outside, knocked by the skin of his teeth on that one, but nonetheless, 2-2.
Stevens with the hit down the shortstop, Tecco. Tecco gets the lead runner at second, but Stevens able to reach first on the fielder's choice.
Yeah, good dig there by Tecco. Stands up, makes the throw. Rider able to get that lead runner.
Tecco definitely gets a game ball for his performance out there at short today, covering a lot of ground and making strong, accurate throws from the hole.
A nice play from short to first earlier in the game from Tecco. Good strong throw, like you say.
Hard bunt. Second baseman got a lot of ground to cover, and he beat him to the bag.
Ooh, I don't know.
I don't know. Might be. First base umpire said yes, he's out.
Man, that's a bang-bang play. That unfortunately, is a bang-bang the umpire play. Was kind of on the backside of the first baseman,
yeah.
So I'm not sure he had as good an angle at it as we did.
Right.
And it looked like Jake Bender just missed the bag with the first step, and it was the second foot coming behind. But nonetheless, they're going to call him out at first after the push bunt.
Still a runner in scoring position for Miami, though, so they can't get too discouraged. Got to put the pass behind him. Focus on the next at-bat. Swung on and slow, high chopper back to Soporowski, who fires over to first, and he'll retire the side to end the seventh inning. Miami and Ryder still tied, nothing. Three hits apiece. Who's going to be the first one to crack the scoreboard?
Yep, top of the eighth inning coming up. We're going to go ahead and take a quick break. Don't go anywhere, RedHawkRadio.com.
Song for the broken hearted.
Back in the action here in Oxford, Ryder University at Miami. It's going to be the second baseman Johnson up against Hendricks, who had a great rebound after getting two runners on base in the last inning, slamming the door with two strikeouts. And he starts out with an 87-mile-per-hour fastball right up near the dome. That'll wake you up. Johnson squaring up to bunt, can't get it back in time, and that's called a strike, 1-1.
Not afraid to head inside, I see.
Inside again, and he fouls this one back behind him. Johnson not liking the inside pitches here, not able to do much with them. Hendricks probably going to stay there. 1-2. Here's the pitch. Swung on and fouled again. Hendricks having a much better start to this inning than he did last. Hendricks delivers. And that was a beautiful 74-mile-per-hour breaking ball that cut right back over the plate and rung him up for strike three. One away, and that's going to bring up Joe Simone.
I don't think Kyle Johnson ever even thought about swinging at that one until he realized it was a strike.
Right. That was beautiful.
Not afraid to go inside to the lefties or the righties is Hendricks. 87 miles per hour there, right about near the belt. Strike one. Simone really close to the plate there.
Yeah, not intimidated by that inside pitch. Kyle Johnson was not either. Hendricks not afraid to try to back him off anyway.
Swung on. Missed there from Simone.
Yeah, cheap fan through swing there from Simone.
Got to commit.
Yeah. Puts Hendrick up on top. 1-2.
Time called. Simone got to collect himself before this two-strike pitch. One and two. Here's the pitch. Taken.
Ooh, trying to slide it in on the outside corner. Just missed by a hair. Unable to get the call was Hendricks.
Blue looked like he was thinking about it for a while, too. Here's the pitch. Stroked in the left field. Looks like Texidor had some trouble with it in the sun. Floated in there into left field, and Ryder's got their fourth hit of the night with one out here in the eighth.
Yeah, good base hit there. Just drops it over Texidor and just short of Winkler out there in left field. Drops in for a single.
At this point in the game, with the way the defenses and the pitching has been, you don't need home runs. You don't need big hits. You just need base runners.
Yeah, only the seventh hit of the game between the two teams combined. Ryder owning that stat column 4-3.
Simone, the only Bronc with two hits. He's 2-for-4 today as he's heading down to second and taking out the second baseman Vogelsgang as he slides in there, beating the throw. Not the greatest throw down. And that's going to put their man in scoring position here with just one out.
Yeah, Sanger didn't get a great jump on the pitch. Throw down to second, like you mentioned, just a bit late. But good speed shown there from the Ryder, University Bronx.
McClure here taking strike one there after working two straight balls, 2-1 here.
Yeah, that's Hendricks' pitch right there, the breaking ball, moving from left to right, right in front of those right-handed batters. Especially helpful when you brush him off the plate with an inside fastball.
That's been his formula today. 3-1 now, not able to get the inside part of the zone, called for a strike.
Curveball here?
That'd be an interesting call. We'll have to see. Here's Hendricks, 3-1. 78, it was the breaking ball, but he does not get the zone. Two men on, but this situation is no stranger to Hendricks as he was able to get out of it just an inning ago.
Yeah, Hendricks kind of seemed scared of his own pitch there. They did go with that left to right breaking ball, but started in the middle of the zone and ended down and away. Unable to snag that strikeout. And Coach Hayden going to head out, have a quick chat with Hendricks.
Yeah, Hayden probably not trying to risk anything here. He's probably seen enough out of Hendricks. Yeah, he's going to take the ball from him. And we're going to have a pitching change here. So Hendricks goes an inning and change, and it's going to be Andy Almquist, the junior out of Liberty Township, just outside of Cincinnati at a Lakota East High School.
Yeah, the local boy here in Butler County, same county that Miami is located in, actually. Almquist, 2.84 ERA on the season, 6 1/3 innings pitched, 7 hits allowed, including 2 runs, but had 7 strikeouts.
Big high overhand delivery. Short arming it. Hovering around 80 with most of his pitches.
Yeah, so he's got his work cut out for him. Runners on first and second with one out. Top of the eighth for Ryder. Good opportunity here to be the first to crack that run column on the scoreboard. Still 0-0 through 7 1/3.
Almquist, though, the junior, he's seasoned. He's been here before. Probably not worried too much about the situation he is being inserted in.
Yeah, I agree. He looks poised. He looks ready. Wrapping up those warm-up pitches. He'll be throwing down to Jake Bender, the first baseman for the Bronx.
Yeah, the middle of this lineup is on tap for Almquist to start out. No easy task.
Yeah, we'll get to see Harding for the first time after this. 333 on the season. Catcher being substituted in.
Inside fastball there. Called a strike. So Almquist comes in, fires in a strike. Got to be good for your confidence as a reliever. Almquist from the stretch. Here's the pitch. Swung on and missed in the dirt. Singer to corral that. Keep it from going anywhere. It's 0-2.
Yeah, good job keeping that ball in front of him. Getting a hand on it. Ready to make a play if necessary. But yeah, that first strike's kind of like a layup or a free throw. Sometimes it's good to just watch a ball go in.
Right. 0-2. One away. Almquist with a big breaking ball inside, 77 miles an hour, but no call there, 1-2.
Yeah, he tried for the 12-6, but like you say, just inside. Good eye there from Bender.
Almquist comes set, checks down at second. Way outside there, Singer having to reach for that one. Definitely tried to... Almquist tried to reach back and get a little bit of extra oomph there for the strikeout. Can't blame him. 2-2. Almquist, the 2-2 to Bender. The pitch. Low in the zone. That's going to be a full count. 3-2. Payoff pitch coming.
Yeah, just missed low. That call's kind of gone back and forth. We were getting it a lot earlier in the game. Started favoring those low inside pitches, but here recently, not quite as generous behind the plate.
Almquist steps off.
It's a big pitch here. Runners on first and second with one out.
The payoff pitch from Almquist. He's going to turn and throw. Vogel's gang coming back to... try and slap the tag down. And here is the payoff pitch. Runners go. Swung on and missed. The throw down to third. And he got him. He got him. He went off the bag. A big mistake there for Ryder University, leaving the bag after sliding in. Might have gotten called safe if he stayed in there, but instead it's a strike him out, throw him out, double play to get out of the inning.
Yeah, Jordan Stevens doing a good job staying aware. I think the throw was just a half second late, but like you mentioned, the base runner sliding over third. Stevens able to regain control of that ball, put the tag on, strike him out, throw him out, double play.
And that could be very well be the deciding factor in this game here late. You know, you think if Ryder has the chance to keep that guy on third, they've got a whole world of opportunities of bringing that guy home. But now we'll never know since he slid over the bag. It's going to be the sidewinder, Jordan Silverman, in now for Ryder, finally relieving Soporowski. Soporowski tosses seven strong innings, only allowing three hits, one walk, and five strikeouts. 93 pitches. That's durability right there.
Yeah, good showing from him. We talked about it all game. Managed that timing and pace really well. Kept those Miami batters on their toes. Able to find the zone with the breaking ball plenty of times. So, good night for Pete Soporowski. Jordan Silverman enters the game with a 4.63 ERA, 1-1 in his two decisions. 11 2/3 innings pitched. Gave up 10 hits. Match that with 10 strikeouts.
Yeah, definitely the velocity won't overpower you being a side armor, but he will have a lot of movement on his pitches. But like you said earlier, it does not look comfortable.
Yeah, like a rubber band inside of that elbow.
Yeah, only topping out at 70, hitting 77 there on his final pitch.
But also missing the zone by about a foot.
Right.
So we'll see if he can give these Miami batters some trouble. Only three hits mustered by the RedHawks so far. Bottom of the eighth inning ahead of us.
Parker Massman, the freshman, standing back in. Massman 0-2 with a strikeout today. Silverman's first pitch is well poked down into right field, but no problem there as that hung up just high enough there for Simone.
Yeah, why not get right after it? Big first cut. Got pretty good contact, but like you said, Simone able to just leg out to right field, nearing the foul line, making that grab.
And it's going to be Stevens again. So he takes that first pitch low and away. Great defensive effort from Stevens in the last inning. We were just talking about it. Was able to reapply the tag after Simone slid over third base as he takes strike one there. And get the RedHawks out of the inning. So you know he's ready to give his guys an opportunity to score right here.
Yeah, we'll see if he can kind of ride that momentum.
Swung on and missed. Clipped foul. 1-2.
Yeah, that ball movement definitely looked like it might have thrown Jordan Stevens off that time.
Steven stares him down. Silverman taking his time. Bit of a different look here for the RedHawks as that's down to Tecco at short. Tecco's been doing it all afternoon. Over to first base and out. So two down here. Silverman making quick work of the bottom part of the RedHawks order. As it's going to be Texador, the nine-hole hitter. He, like so many others, hitless in this contest. Here with two outs, here's Silverman's first pitch to him. Low and inside, 66 on the gun, 1-0.
Yeah, you mentioned a moment ago, but Silverman much more methodical, taking his time.
As that one is hit foul. Down the right field line. Yeah, it doesn't seem like they're able to really key in on a timing there. And that sidearm motion, obviously a big part of the problem. 1-1, two outs. Carlos Texador up. Texador with
a mirror image of the last pitch, hitting that one foul down the right field line.
Yeah, Silverman just stutters just the slightest bit during that windup.
And that can pay big, big dividends for a pitcher that's trying to keep people off balance.
Yeah, you mentioned that with the sidearm and a little bit of movement, like you say, definitely throw off a batter.
2-2 now from Silverman. Texador trying to keep the inning alive. And here's the pitch. Swung on, hit out to second base. Routine, though, and that'll retire the side in the eighth for Miami. So Ryder getting good mileage out of their reliever, Silverman. Going to have to send Almquist back out there. Hope he can do the same yet again.
Yeah, Silverman three up, three down, just like that. Still scoreless headed into the top of the ninth inning, so RedHawks can hold them here and then have a chance to take the game in the bottom of the ninth.
You'd love to see that, wouldn't you? Nice ninth inning thriller. RedHawks have won in extra innings earlier this season, beating Campbell College in the tournament in Campbell in 11 innings. So they are no stranger to free baseball.
Yep, Miami, like we mentioned before, able to snag that win from Ryder yesterday, 5-1. They'll come back and finish the series tomorrow. We will have that game as well, RedHawkRadio.com. And on Monday, Miami basketball gets a shot at the MAC tournament. We'll be at home in Millett Hall, so you can catch that one on Red Hawk Radio as well. Our friends Hans and Kenny will be having that call. Big basketball guys. Big basketball
and
guys.
And they have really done a tremendous job this year, the Miami basketball team. Guys like Jalen Attaway, Precious Aya. I mean, that's been a really good team. As McAllister, another catcher, comes in, taking ball one from Almquist. Isaiah Coleman lands. Yes, they've really put together a really complete squad in Millett for Miami basketball this year. 2-0 here to McAllister. 3-0 now, as Almquist not budging from the location on his first three pitches. Almquist with a finally able to get a strike with, it looked like, the same exact pitch as he had thrown the last three times. So 3-1 now.
Yeah, McAllister thought so too. Two steps towards first base.
And McAllister swinging and missing now. And Almquist able to work it back to a full count.
Yep, junior from Delaware fouls that one off. 5'10", 180-pounder. Batting lefty right now.
And high, very, very high and outside. And McAllister, off the bench cold, is going to work a walk.
Yeah, that's a guy you really should go after. It's tough when you start down 0-3. Like you mentioned, straight out of the dugout, a little bit cold. Would have been a good opportunity there. Unable to capitalize, were the Red Hawks. So, runner on first with no outs, top of the ninth, still scoreless.
It's going to be Jake Barbary up again.
Showing bunt.
Well placed down the first base line.
Yep. Gets it down, no problem. Great job coming in, making the play as Haffey. Getting the tag down on the line. So, sack bunt successful. Moves the runner to second base. One out for Ryder.
That play can be very, very confusing for a lot of teams. You know, the first baseman leaving it up to the pitcher sometimes and causing all types of confusion. But it was a good job for Haffey to be authoritative and take that and put the tag down. It's going to be Mahalik now, the designated hitter, as he fouls the first pitch behind home plate.
visit to the mound from Matt Davis, one of the assistant coaches for Miami University. Have a quick chat. Try to hash out a game plan here. Up 0-1 in the count. We'll see what Almquist brings.
Nobody up throwing in the Miami bullpen yet, or the Rider bullpen. Miami Hayden dedicated to letting Almquist see this one through. Swung on and missed there from Mahalik. Good pitch there from Almquist. It'll be 0-2. One away.
Well, this is where you want to be with a runner on second, ahead in the count 0-2.
Almquist kicks and deals. Way outside there. Tried to expand the zone there for strike three. Not a bad idea, but unable to get the swing.
Yeah, you get a guy nervous. You send him one outside, see if he'll go fishing for it. Unsuccessful, but 1-2.
Here's the pitch. Low in the dirt even. 2-2.
89 on the gun that time, so picking up the speed. Unfortunately, lost control a little bit.
Almquist definitely trying to reach back and get as much as zip as he can on all his pitches, as he knows this is crunch time now. Waved at the breaking ball and missed. 76 on the gun. Two down here. And that'll bring up Dallas Clark, no relation.
Yeah, you know, I think that was something that Ryder and Mahalik weren't really ready for. And Almquist brings 89 and then goes right back to that off-speed that he had been throwing before. So good job mixing up the speeds and getting the base better. Excuse me.
Big hanging breaking ball. Almost deadly there. 1-0. You got to be careful here. It's late in the game. You cannot afford to throw a cookie into the strike zone. Almquist, 88 there, right down Broadway. Dallas Clark wanted it, but he fouls it off. Good job mixing speeds, like you said, with Almquist. Doing everything he can to keep Ryder off the board. Swung on and missed. Big swing high in the zone. Just cheesed him. 89, way up there.
Oh, yeah, kind of bouncing back and forth is Almquist. Two outs, runner still on second.
Dallas Clark, the senior, swinging at that high fastball. He knows better, and he comes right back with a ball up the middle. Coming home's the runner to the plate. Throw offline. Clark going to second, though, and, oh, it's the throws offline at second, and that's going to be a run scored here for Ryder University.
Yeah, so the Bronx break open the game. First run coming in the top of the ninth.
Well, it was a good job bouncing back from Dallas Clark, just as I was critiquing him for swinging at that high fastball. He ropes a single right back up the middle and ends up on second base from the throw home that was offline, and it's now 1-0 Ryder. Almquist still in there. Still has a job to do as he fires back in a strike after serving up the RBI single. Almquist getting a little bit quicker with his delivery.
Man, I'm not sure where that pitch was. I think the ump might have said upstairs, but looked good from here.
Looked good from up here.
Didn't give it to him. 1-1.
Shortstop Teco in now. Been doing great defensively today.
Yeah, a couple really nice plays. Had a good dig in the last inning and a great throw from short earlier in the game to get a runner at first. Definitely have to give props to Richie Teco for his defensive prowess.
2-1 now, working the count. fouled off. Deuces wild. Two balls, two strikes, and two outs. One nothing Ryder. Swung on and missed. Foul tip. And Almquist able to get out of the inning before any more damage is done. So Ryder up 1-0. A fast return by the RedHawks to the dugout. They want to get back out there and try and hit.
Yep, Miami with a chance at redemption. Three hits on the game, yet to find a tally in the run column. This will be their last chance, down to their final three outs. Back out to the mound is Silverman, the sidewinder.
Yeah, but it doesn't look like it'll be too easy for the RedHawks here in the bottom of the ninth, as he was able to post a shutout inning in his first inning of work. That low sidearm action, obviously giving the RedHawks fits. But not only that, we talked about it a little bit. He's got that stutter once he starts to bring his arm through that is just so devastating. It really throws a hitter's timing off. They start to pick their foot up and start to get their swing going, but he stops for almost half a second. So it's going to be Kyle Winkler, top of the order. Something you want in this situation, the top of your lineup coming on in the ninth.
Yeah, Miami unable to muster up a whole lot of offense today. But the stage is set now. Only three hits for the RedHawks so far.
Three hits, and Winkler with one of them. One for three. He's got a hit and a strikeout today. Silverman's ready. Here's the delivery. Strike one called. Low in the zone, 79. Good pitch there from Silverman.
Yeah, Silverman not intimidated, getting right after it. Putting balls in the zone.
Yanks down the left field line, but foul. Winkler had another hit like that earlier. Was his first hit. His only hit was a ball yanked just inside the third base bag a couple innings ago. He'd like to duplicate that in this at-bat.
Yeah, just turned his wrists over that one and pulled it just a bit foul. But Barbary hugging the bag this time as to not get beat on that third base side again.
One and two. Here's Silverman. Too low. Two and two. 68 on the gun. So not overpowering with the velocity, but the delivery and the throwing motion, what's getting the RedHawks. Ripped by Barbary with a diving effort in the left field. Winkler going to make a wide turn there at first to make sure, but he's going to have a leadoff single. So the stage is set here for the RedHawks. Tying run at first, the go-ahead run at the plate.
Yeah, he said, all right, Barbary, you want to take six steps over there and stand right next to third base, and I'll hit it six steps to the righty and put it in play anyways.
Great placement there. And now they got Silverman on the ropes here with nobody out. Hall back up at the plate, 0 for 3 today. Had some good looks today, but not able to get anything fall in his favor. He's going to square to bunt, and he sets down a really nice bunt there. First baseman trying to see if it will go foul, and it will stay fair.
Wow, the turf giving him some trouble.
Wow.
Bender. Yeah, thought he was going to have a cheeky play there, just let it roll out. But straddled the line, spun a little bit, and kicked back in towards the mound. So both runners are safe.
Wow, what good way to stay with it from Hall to just keep running down the first base line and leg that infield single out, that bunt single out. So two men on, nobody out.
tying run at second, the winning run at first. And it's Haffey, the big first baseman up now, who had a home run last night. Silverman steps off.
Yeah, Silverman has to be careful here. If he leaves one up in the zone, there's nothing to say. Haffey won't walk off with it.
Here's Haffey. Fresh count. Inside, lost by the catcher.
Yeah,
good sub.
Yeah, good recovery there from McAllister. Hopping out on top of it, keeping everybody still out on the base pads.
Well, you know Haffey wants this, but not getting too overzealous as Silverman spins and throws back to try and get Winkler napping. You know, that would be a big confidence boost for Ryder to erase that lead runner with a nice cheeky pickoff.
Yep, Haffey's just got to be patient here. Wait for his pitch.
Taken. Ball two.
Yeah, good eye. Wouldn't be surprised if they continue to try to work the outside of the zone. Haffey's just got to wait for that slip up and then strike.
Hayden making some signage over there. Maybe a hit and run looming.
Wow, McAllister tried to frame that one but did not get the call. Outside again. Three balls now.
Wow.
Yeah, walking the bases loaded with no outs is never ideal, especially not up a run in the bottom of the ninth.
Well, and with the performance Silverman had last inning, this is night and day. The pitch. Big cut there. But foul, 3-1, still a hitter's count. Haffey is still in the driver's seat. Looking down at Hayden, trying to make something happen here in the bottom of the ninth.
Yeah, that's a good one to swing on. Silverman brought it back into the zone. Haffey just sent it foul.
Here's Silverman, the pitch. Haffey yanks this one down right field, straighten it out a little bit more. And you've got yourself a good hit, but unfortunately, just missing that one. So it's a full count, 3-2. The payoff pitch going to be on its way. Here's the pitch. Chop foul there from Haffey. Count remains 3-2.
Yeah, just got on top of that pitch. If Haffey hits that one cleanly, got a good shot at being a base hit, driving in that taunting run. Still no outs with a runner on first and second. Miami down one, bottom of the ninth.
And Haffey stares him down. Here's the pitch. Lifted foul again. Runners going.
Yeah, hit and run was on that time. Forced to bring out some more baseballs from the dugout. Haffey sent all of them to the parking lot.
Gotta know this is starting to get under the skin of Silverman. Who will crack first? Silverman's got two strikes on him, but three balls. Here's the pit. Oh, he bluffs a move back to second base. Winkler trots back in there easily with no throw. Hall on first, Winkler on second. Haffey up at the plate here in the bottom of the ninth. Throw over, back to Winkler. Winkler's in there safe.
Yeah, eighth pitch of the at-bat on its way from Silverman. So Haffey doing a good job fouling him off a couple times.
Here's the pitch. Silverman taking all the time he can. He wants to make a perfect pitch. Haffey yanks this one into left field. Winkler going to stop at third. Hall going to stop at second. The bases are loaded.
Well, a good rip from Haffey. Got ahead early. Just waited and waited. Finally found his pitch. Stroked it down left field. Moved the runners. Coach Hayden wisely holding at third. So bases loaded with no outs. And it's the designated hitter, Landon Stevens, up at the plate.
You know, Landon Stevens could send Ryder not back home, but could send Ryder back to their hotel room. Losers tonight with one swing. And the series win on the line for Miami as well.
That's right. Like we mentioned, a 5-1 victory last night. And they'll finish up the series tomorrow. 3-game homestand for the RedHawks. First of its kind this season. So this is where it gets fun. Bottom of the ninth, bases loaded. Nobody out. Miami RedHawks down a run at home.
Designated hitter Landon Stevens up. The local Hamilton boy, the sophomore. Takes that one low. Strike one.
Yep, Silverman sneaking that one into the zone last second.
Ryder's got someone up and throwing just in case. Looks like number 40, Vincent Vitacco out of Staten Island. Outside, ball one. Stevens able to even the count back up. One and one. Silverman with 24 pitches as Stevens hits this one down to third. And Winkler will be out.
Yeah, McAllister able to get the force. Didn't get the tag down, but dropped his foot there on the home plate. So unfortunate placement there on that hit. Straight to the third baseman. Pretty easy play at home. Nonetheless, base is still loaded and only one out.
Good awareness there by the third baseman, Barbary, to throw down to home and keep that run off the board. Ryder still trying to secure the win here in this inning. Up 1-0. Ducks on the pond for Vogelsgang, who coming into this game, as we said earlier, hitting a monstrous 400. 419 on base percentage as well. Couple RBIs. 5 runs scored. Also, the speed is there for Vogelsgang, as he was 6-for-6 on stolen bases last season as a freshman.
Yeah, speaking of speed, Coach Hayden going to sub in Christian Tejada as a pinch runner on second base. So, deep fair ball. Potential to win it here.
Vogelsgang, half-hearted swing there. That's a strike, 0-1. Silverman down low, 1-1.
Yeah, looking a little more confident now. Got his rhythm back, picking up the pace just a bit. Silverman grabs rubber. He looks ready again.
Swing and a miss. That time fully committed to that swing, but came up with nothing. It's 1-2. Still only one out here for the RedHawks. So not desperation mode yet.
Yeah, the second baseman stretching a bit on that strike.
Vogelsgang. Ooh, low in the dirt, swings and misses, called out. And now, here with two men out, here in the bottom of the ninth, it's Singer, the catcher.
Well, now it's Miami on the ropes, two outs. Started with the bases loaded and no outs in this inning. Silverman doing a good job battling back, picking up two in a row.
Silverman's first pitch. Inside strike. Good pitch. Ryder and Miami pitchers have loved going to that part of the zone all game long. And there it is again, paying dividends here for Silverman. 0-1 to the catcher.
Here's the pitch.
Singer hits this one deep into right center field. That is all the way to the wall. One run scores. The second run scores. And Miami University has just walked off Ryder for the series win. 2-1 here with two outs, bases loaded. My goodness, what a finish for Miami. Not a single run until the ninth inning.
Yeah.
It's exciting.
I'll tell you what, it's all day on both sides of the ball. Miami seemed like they'd be in a hole, battle right back defensively a ton of times, and then obviously here in the ninth inning, load them up with no outs. You let Silverman climb back in, pick up two back-to-back, and then just like that, a deep fair ball to right center field will bring in two runs. Tejada ahead by a lot.
Yes.
At that throw to the plate. And Miami walks off in Oxford on Saturday.
What a game. Spears turning in a great start, allowing no runs. But that's not to say that Soporowski for Ryder didn't turn in a great start. I mean, both pitchers, the whole pitching staff for both teams did a wonderful job all game long. But at the end of the day, it was a well-placed, well-struck ball from Singer that put things out of reach.
Yeah, the big walk-off from him. But, yeah, I still think Soporowski might have been the story of the game. Seven innings pitch, gave up three hits, had five strikeouts. His pace and timing were just good all game. Unfortunately, Silverman kind of lost his edge there in the bottom of the ninth.
Mm-hmm. It's going to be Silverman with the loss. And Almquist is going to get the win. I think there at the end, Silverman just threw too many pitches. You know, he is a reliever. Relievers aren't typically used to throwing 30 pitches in an appearance. And that supposedly proved to be the X factor, it appears.
Yeah, you know, it's the halfy at-bat, too, that helps play into that. If you take, like you say, a reliever who's not used to throwing a ton of pitches and you take him 8-9 in a single at-bat, really start to wear on a guy, especially one that throws that sidearm ball.
Right. Probably the turning point, though, in the game for me would be when Stevens was able to reapply the tag down there at third base and keep Ryder from, you know, maybe amounting a two-out rally to score before the ninth inning.
Yeah, I think that's absolutely a fair statement. He missed the throw was just a bit late coming from Singer, but able to recover and get that secondary tag down was huge for the RedHawks to get out of that jam. Big strike him out, throw him out, double play. Well, that's it for us today here in Oxford. Thank you for joining us on this wonderful Saturday. Miami walks off and beats Ryder 2-1. Take the series win, but we've still got one more. Please join us tomorrow, 1 p.m. game time. So prime Sunday afternoon slot for the RedHawks and the Bronx face off in their third in a row. We'll have the call here on RedHawk Radio. Signing off for Houston Vick and Stephen Perkins, that's baseball.